And this is going to be a relatively quick tutorial compared to all my other ones. I know lately I've been making a lot of tutorials that are spanning out and getting so long that they have to be within three different segments. Actually, I think like six different segments at the most so far. Actually, those other ones aren't up yet, but I'm coming to you soon with three more, I believe, add-ons to the adding a user database to your iPhone or iPad application tutorial set. Okay, so this is going to be a tutorial on NSUserDefaults and how to save information with them. NSUserDefaults are very useful because you can save things like a username, a high score within an iPhone. You can save a bool for like yes or no or whatever. You could save a background image if you have changeable background images, all that wonderful stuff. So that's basically what a bool is, and now to teach you guys how to use it. So just go right into Xcode and just create a new project. The only thing that we'll need for this is just a plain old view-based application. The only thing that I think I'll actually be running in the simulator right now is basically just this saving text to show you guys, like, input it, text into your text field, saves it for the next launch. But basically, everything that I'll be showing you right now is just saving and retrieving information with it that won't be displayed to the user. It'll be within the app. Sorry, my computer's really slow. It's been processing a lot of videos for you guys. Still is. Why is it messed up? There we go. Okay. Okay, it should be creating a new project any day now. Okay, there we go. Sorry, this is unbearably slow. So, just go into your viewcontroller.m file. And if we go into the view data mode, we won't need anything really besides maybe a text field in a few seconds or minutes, whatever. So, here. Basically, the basic way to start off an NSUserDefault, or to set up an NSUserDefault, is like this. NSUserDefaults, standard defaults, set object for key. And so the for key is the name of the NSUserDefault. So whatever this could be, you could change this to set bool, to set integer. This is just set object, so we could add a bunch of different kinds of objects into there. But so basically, this is the name of it. This is how we're going to retrieve it. So let's call it test default. And we'll set object to hello. Just there you go. And then the way that you retrieve it is okay. So let's just create a string. Yes, string. Why is that not working? Oh, forgot this. Okay. And a string. String equals. Now this is just for a string. You could say also bool. Yes. Or something like that. Or, so bool test equals then as NSUserDefaults. This is the same, you retrieve it all the same way, but you just put it in value or the variable type that you entered it. So, your defaults, standard defaults. So we entered in a string, so string for key. Now we can basically just copy that and just say bool for key. That's exactly the same way, but we don't have the bool yet, so let's just delete that. But so that is how you set a user default, and then you can retrieve it. So you could put a variable in here if you had one, you could just delete that, put in a variable, and then you're good to go. So it's basically just that simple. Now let's just create a really little simple text field and save the text in there. So first create an IB action. Close text field. Okay, so we set up our action. Then we want to get the text field. IB outlet UI text field. Let's just say field. Okay, so then you go into your .m and say in the view to load field dot text equals NS user defaults standard defaults string for key. Saved text. And then we can just copy this down here and use most of it over here. And then so object. Okay, so set object text field dot text and field dot text for the same text. And that's all you have to put in your dot m. It's that easy. How to save a string. Really simple. Okay. Now we go into our view controller dot xi. Never decides to load. And there we go. Okay. So all we gotta put on here is a text field. So we just hook up the field, then you want to hook up close field to did end on exit. This will mean that when you press the enter button, it will actually work, unlike the default keyboard, which is not set up to work. So when you press the enter key, it will actually work. It'll close the text field. Not only will it close the text field, it will save the text in it with the action that happens when you close it, which is to save the object. Okay, so just save and quit interface builder. We're running in the simulator. Now, my simulator is the 4.0 beta, but it's the same for you guys. It won't make any difference. Okay. Succeeded. Installing the simulator. It's loading. Okay. So, let's just put a random piece of text in here. Like, hello world. Press return. Go back into it, and it says, hello world. Wonderful. So, we have just told it to save the NSUserDefault. And, that's basically it, guys. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for my next tutorial.